Assalamu alaikum, hope you are doing well. As I get the comment in my last video to make a video about the embassy questions and answer about the embassy interview. So I have a list about that, and in this list I include my experience and my friend's experience and the students who came in the last month. So I just text them and get the answer what they ask from what the embassy ambassador asked from them. Not the ambassador, it's called the consulate. What the consular asked from them. So first of all, there are some genuine questions like about yourself, like in your introduction he asked like what is your name, age, and what's your father name, and how many siblings you are, and what they do. So you must have to be prepared for yourself, like what's your siblings do, they are studying or either they are married. And the second question they ask, which is the most important one, I think, who is going to support you, your study and expenses, who is going to like support, how, what is, actually they are going to ask how you will manage your fees structure, either you are going there for work or either you are going only for study, because for a student it is not allowed here to work during their studies. And in the third questions they will ask you what is your father occupation. So you know everyone, if your father is a businessman, if your father is a professor or teacher, government employer, so you can say that whatever you, what is your father occupation. So in number four question that I get, in vacations, would you like to go to stay or go to your country? So it's up to you, how is your plan, like if you want to come in the vacations to your home, so you can say yeah I will come. If you want to say like no, I will stay there and I will enjoy the summer of Ukraine because it's too good, you can also say like that, but it's up to you, and be honest in your answer. In the fifth question, he asked from my friend, in which field of medicine would you like to be specialist? Like he is asking about your future, in which field you are going to be a specialist, like heart, maybe you can say I want to be a cardiologist, I want to be a neurologist, I want to be a nephrologist, or something else in which like you know, say something about that, like if you are say I want to be a neurologist, he might ask a question about the brain, how many parts of the brain and what their work, a little bit, not so much deep, because he also doesn't know anything. He doesn't know anything except a few basic things, because he is a counselor and you are a good medical student, a pre-medical student, so you know more than him. So be confident about giving answer about the medical. Even you are going to give answer wrong and you know by yourself that you are wrong, just keep trying to answer, because he didn't want your knowledge, because you are coming here be a doctor, you are not a doctor, and either you are coming here for computer science or something else, so just be confident. And in the seventh question he can ask about in the sixth question, why Ukraine for medicine, why you choose Ukraine only, there are many other multiple options like Kyrgyzstan, China, Kazakhstan, Iran, especially for Indian student, we have Philippines and some other countries. I'm not telling you about England, Australia, New Zealand, because they have a separate comparison. I can't compare Ukraine with Australia and England. And in most of the questions that I get, like would you prefer either Kyrgyzstan, Kazakhstan, or Ukraine? If you are China, if you are going to do the comparison between these countries like China and Ukraine and Kyrgyzstan and Kazakhstan, so I will prefer Ukraine. There are multiple reasons I will tell in another video. What are these reasons why you choose Ukraine and not these countries? And if you are going to compare the Ukraine and England or maybe Australia or USA, so there is no comparison. There is no like even there is no. How to say, like there is no comparison, we can't compare them, they are so high, their education level, USA, America is so high. And in the seventh question that I have, why KNMU, why Kharkiv National Medical University, and why you specifically choose this university? So you have a good answer for specifically Pakistani students, they can say In the Ukraine, there is only one university which is in the A list of PMC, Pakistan Medical Commission. But like in Europe, for Indian students, they have multiple answers. I can see they have a lot of Indian students are studying, so they have their different opinions. And the most important questions: would you like to learn Ukrainian language? Yeah, you can say yeah. Definitely, I have to learn Ukrainian language to survive there and to communicate with the others and to participate in the discussions. And you can say also, you can go to the hospital without Ukrainian language. You can't communicate with you can't communicate with the peoples who are living here. So it's a compulsory one. You must have to learn this. And the ninth question I have: will you stay in the hostel or flat? So you can say, first of all, you will stay in the hostel, because you can't say I will stay in the flat and something like that, because here in KNMU, Kharkiv National Medical University, we have a lot of hostels. But it's your choice. When you will arrive here, it's up to you. You wanna live in the hostel or either in flat. So, but in front of the consular, to save yourself, you can say I will live in the hostel because I don't know anything from there, and I don't have any experience. I don't know the language, and I don't know how to get the apartment. So in future, maybe I can transfer from hostel to flat. But now I am going to hostel. So it will save your point. It will give you answer why, what is your in the rejection one, when you get a refusal. I'm not saying you are getting a refusal of letter, refusal of visa. So in the refusal of visa, there are multiple options, and in the most person who get the refusal, they get the refusal by what is their intent to stay. Why they can't say they are living in the hostel or either in the flat. So this is the main basic reason, I think, the refusal of the visa. So the next question, the question number 10, I have the what is the fee structure. As you know, the fee structure is $2,400 per semester and up to so on, from first semester to last. And then we have the question: how you get your invitation letter, and who invited you to study in Ukraine? I think this is a most important question. This is also the important question, because you get your invitation letter by multiple way. So you can say that I just apply on the university site and I get my invitation letter. You can say that I apply to a different company, or you can say your agent name through whom you are applying in the university, and you are getting your invitation letter. And then I have another question: any friend or family member in Ukraine? You have any a friend or family member in Ukraine? If you know some friend who are already studying here, so you can mention their name. If not, so it's up to you. And other thing, the most important thing, the unpredictable question I get: what is the address of your university? So the address of Kharkiv National Medical University is Prospect Naukova 4. I will write in the video, Prospect Naukova 4. This is the Scientific Avenue. This is the Prospect Naukova 4, Scientific Avenue, Kharkiv. This is the actual proper address of the university. And the 14th question: are you going to work in Ukraine while studying? So definitely you have to say no, I'm not going. Even you have plan that you are going to work, you will do a part-time job and something like that, so you definitely said no, I'm not going to work, I'm going only for studies there. Okay. And the last question maybe he will ask from you: what's your future plan, what you are gonna do? So it's what you wanna go on and do. You will go to for England lab, either you will go to your own country, or either you will go to some other country. This is just a simple question: what's your specialty? So it's up to you. And the last one, that the medical related question, he can ask about the biology, the basic biology that we study in the 11 and 12. So the question that I get my friends are get in the interview are these, what is the parts of the heart, what are the parts of the lungs, and how many lungs, how many kidneys, how many ureter, how many lobes of liver, what is the function of kidney, and something like how many intestine we have. So he doesn't know anything. He just checked that either you know even a single thing or not. I think even sixth class student also know about these square answers. And the one question that I get from the other biology is what is the difference between autotroph, heterotroph, and one is more autotroph, heterotroph, and something like a parasite. What is a parasite, virus, and parasite, virus, and bacteria? These are the questions that mostly counselor ask. So these are the list of the questions that you can face in the embassy. In any embassy, I'm talking about the Ukrainian embassy, but if you are going to apply the visa for Italy or maybe somewhere else, so these are the main basic questions that he can ask from you. Hope you guys enjoy this video. If you think it's informative for you, please subscribe and press the like button and share with your friends who are coming to Ukraine.